Dear children, as we are dealing with the topic The Third Level by Jack Finney, here the narrator, whose name is Charlie, tells us about the third level, that is at the Grand Central Station. While other people and his friend Sam, who is a psychiatrist, believe that there are only two levels, but Charlie is firm in his belief and he tells everyone that there are three levels. Children, here the man Charlie, he is living in an imaginary world, the world where the things doesn't exist in reality. It is just his imagination about that third level. Now let us continue the story. There is probably a long tunnel that nobody knows. Now he's talking about that third level at the Grand Central Station, that there is a long tunnel and nobody knows about that tunnel. And its way is under the city right now. He tells that the city in which he is living in, that tunnel is under that. Okay? And the route goes from the Grand Central Station on its way to Times Square. He also tells that, and it reaches to Times Square. Times Square is a place and maybe another to Central Park. Here he tells us about the route of that tunnels, means there are different routes in that tunnels. One reaches to Central Square, Central Park, and another reaches to Times Square. And maybe, then he guessed, because for so many people through the years, Grand Central has been an exit. And he here tells us that the third level is like an exit for the people for many years. He means to say that the people who want to escape from the reality of life, they just go down through the tunnel and they reaches to a new world. Maybe that's how the tunnel I got into. And here he says that perhaps he also reached in that tunnel, because we know that Charlie also wants to escape from the problems of his life. But I never told my psychiatrist friend about that idea. Here he says that, but he never shared this idea with his friend Sam. The corridor I was in began angling left. Now, because here he was at the corridor of that third level, he tells us that he began to turn left and slanting downward. Means he walked towards left, then he just started walking downwards. And I thought that was wrong. Firstly, he thought it was wrong, but he kept on walking on that route. All I could hear was the empty sound of my own footsteps. When he was walking through the tunnel, he heard only the sound of his footsteps, and I didn't pass a soul. He didn't see a single man there. Then I heard that sort of hollow roar ahead. That means open space and people talking. Then he heard hollow sound there, roaring sound, which seems that people are talking to each other, and it is an open space. The tunnel turned sharp left. Then he took a sharp left at the tunnel. He went down a short flight of stairs. There were small stairs and he crossed them and came out on the third level at Grand Central Station. And definitely he reached to the third level at the Grand Central Station. For just a moment, I thought I was back on the second level. For a moment, he thought he was back at the place from where he started his journey. But I saw the room was smaller, but he found that the room was smaller than the second level. There were fewer ticket windows, and as compared to second level, there were fewer ticket windows and train gates. Okay, and the information booth in the center was wood and old looking. And the information booth, that center where from where he could get the information about the trains, it was made up of wood and old looking. It was looking like old, it belonged to old time. And the man in the booth wore a green eyeshade. He saw that the man who was in the booth, he were wearing green eyeshade. Means he had put eyeshade on his on the upper part of his eyes, and long black sleeve protectors. At the same time, he had worn long ब्लैक कलर्ड स्लीव प्रोटेक्टर्स. स्लीव प्रोटेक्टर्स आर द प्रोटेक्टर्स विच आर यूज टू यू नो प्रोटेक्ट योर स्लीव्स फ्रॉम द डस्ट एंड अदर थिंग्स. The lights were dim, and the lights were dim there and sort of flickering. Flickering means moving. They were just moving lights, okay, like twinkling. Then I saw why. Then he found why they were like that, because they were open flame gas lights, because they were not the lights at the present time. They were the gas lights, means the lights were burning with the help of gas and they were open, okay. Then that's why they were flickering. Then there were brass spittoons on the floor. He saw that there were brass spittoons also. Spittoons means a container which is used to spit. And across the station, a glint of light caught my eye. He looked across the station at the other side. He found that a light was there, which was a flashlight. A man was pulling a gold watch from his vest pocket, and he found there a man who was pulling a gold watch from his vest pocket, means from the pocket of his undershirt. He snapped open the cover. He snapped means he quickly opened the cover of the watch, glanced at his watch and frowned. He just looked at his watch and then he frowned, means he showed the angry expressions on his face. He wore a derby hat. The man had wearing a derby hat is a round hat having a round portion on its top, a black four button suit, and also a suit which had four buttons and with tiny lapels. Okay, generally lapels are part of a coat below the collar which is folded back on either side of the front opening. Okay children. And he had a big black handlebar mustache, and also he had a big mustache, and on the both side of the mustache there were handle. Okay, they were in a shape of a handle. Then I looked around and saw that everyone in the station was dressed like 1890 something. Then he found everyone there dressed like 1890, means year 1890. I never saw so many bears. In his life, he never saw such kind of bears. Sideburns. Sideburns are the hair grown near the ears, okay, in order to form a bear. And fancy mustaches in my life. And those kinds of fancy, like he says, handlebar mustache. The mustaches having different kinds of design on the faces of the men. A woman walked in through the train gate. He saw also a woman who walked through the gate. She wore a dress with a leg of mutton sleeves. Now, leg of mutton sleeves, children, these are all kinds of sleeves. Looks like leg, mutton leg, okay? And skirts to the top of her high button shoes. And she had worn a skirt. And also, she was wearing high button shoes. Okay, back of her out on the tracks, I caught a glimpse of a locomotive. Now on the back side of the woman, he saw on the track, means railway track, he caught a glimpse. Glimpse means he quickly looked a locomotive. Now locomotive is a kind of train, okay. It has funnel stack, a very small courier and Ives locomotive, and the train was very small, made by Courier and Ives. These are the names of the men who invented that locomotive. And with a funnel shaped stack. Funnel shaped stacks means it is on the top of it in the front, and it is used to expel smoke from an engine, that funnel shaped. Okay. And then I knew. And then he came to know to make sure. What he came to know? He came to know that he had gone to that world which belonged to 1890. To make sure, I walked over to a newsboy and glanced at the stack of papers. To make sure this thing, whether he is living in the present time or in 19th century, that is 1890. He went to the newsboy. Newsboy means a boy who was having newspapers. Stack means piles of newspaper at his feet. It was the world. The newspaper titled The World, means the name of the newspaper was The World, and The World hasn't been published for years. Then Charlie came to know about the newspaper that it hasn't been published for years, means it has been stopped many years ago, and now no news is published in such kind of newspaper. So it was also another sign for him to believe that he was living in 1890, okay, in 19th century. The lead story said something about President Cleveland, and there was a headlines about Cleveland, who is also now at present time no more. I have found that front page since in the public library files, and it was printed June 11, 1894. He says that he had found such kind of newspaper in public library also, and where he had seen the date June 11, 1894. Now he was confirmed that he had come to the era of 1894. I turned toward the ticket windows, knowing that here on the third level at Grand Central, I could buy tickets that would take Louisa and me anywhere in the United States we wanted to go. Now an idea came in his mind, and that was about buying the tickets, because he knew that that time the tickets were not so costly. So he thought to buy the tickets to go anywhere in the United States, and he wanted to buy the tickets for himself and for his wife. In the year 1894, okay, and that was the year 1894, and I wanted two tickets to Galesburg, Illinois. It is a place in US, and he wanted to go there with his wife. Have you ever been there? Here he asked a question to the readers, that have you ever been there at Galesburg, Illinois? It is a wonderful town still, with a big old frame houses, huge lawns, and tremendous trees whose branches meet overhead and roof of the streets. He just describes here the town, the city, that it is very beautiful city, and having the old frame houses, the houses which are old fashioned, and huge lawns. They have their lawns, means the garden in front of their house, having green grass on it, and tremendous trees. The trees which are there in that city are very tall, and their branches can reach to the roof of the streets. And in 1894, summer evenings were twice as long. He also talks about those evenings, that those evenings were longer. Okay, and people sat out on their lawns. The people, they used to sit on their lawns in those evenings. The men smoking cigars and talking quietly. The women waving palm leaves, fans with fire flies all around, in a peaceful world. Now here he gives us the picture of a peaceful world of 1894, where the people are sitting in their lawns, having their cigars. The women are waving the palm leaves, fans, means the fans are made up of palm leaves. They are not the fan like we have today, made up of metal. So here he is also telling us about the fireflies. Fireflies are kind of insects. When there is dark around us, there is they seems to bring light in themselves. Okay, to be back there with the First World War still 20 years off. And he tells us that he is now in 1894, and there are 20 years for the World War still. Means 20 years after there will be World War, and World War II over 40 years in the future. And he talks about another World War also, which will take place in future after 40 years. I wanted two tickets for that. And here again he says that, but he wanted to go there to the place, to Galesburg, and wanted two tickets. Here children, these all things tell us that the narrator Charlie is peace-loving man, and he is fed up of the problems of present times. Like he is totally disappointed by the world wars, and he doesn't want any war now at his time. That's why he wants to go back to 1894, in that peaceful era, peaceful world. So children, that's all for today. Rest we will discuss in next class. Till then, thank you.